Good afternoon, children. What we have done yesterday in our previous lecture, that is, we have studied about elements, mixtures, and compounds. Differences also we have studied. Second chapter we are doing, that is, the matter around us, is it pure or not? If we say that it is pure, then it can be an element or it can be a compound. If we talk about element, then we say that it is made up of only one kind of atoms. And all the atoms of one element, they are exactly alike, they are similar in mass, similar in size, and similar in density, but they differ from the atom of other element. That is what we have seen yesterday, that we have compared an atom of iron with an atom of silver, and we have seen that all the atoms of iron, they are similar, all the atoms of silver, they are similar, but if we compare the atom of iron with atom of silver, then there is quite a lot of difference. Then what is a compound? It is made up of two or more elements combined together in fixed proportion. We have taken the example of water. Then mixture, two or more things mixed in any proportion, but they do not react with each other. That is mixture. All the properties also we have discussed. Now today we are going to discuss about the physical and chemical changes. Physical and chemical changes. As we all know, children, that there are three states of matter, that is solid, liquid and gas. And this is what? This is the physical state of matter. Now, what is a physical change? Physical means related to the physics. As already we are knowing that there are three states of matter, three physical states, solid, liquid and gas. And change of course is there. So let us define first what is a physical change. In a physical change, only the physical properties of the substances changes. Only the physical properties of the substances changes, but no new substance is formed. No new substance is formed. So, what is a physical change? Only the physical property of the substances, they change, but no new substance is formed. Just take the example of ice. This ice, it is what? It is solid. When it melts, then what happens? It changes into water. And what is water? It is a liquid. So the physical state has changed from solid to liquid without the formation of new substance. No new substance is formed means, if you want to change this water into ice, again you can easily change. How you can change? By this thing, freezing it. Again, you can freeze the water and you can get the ice. This will again be a physical change, that is from liquid to solid state, but without formation of new substance. If suppose you have, this is a chalk. If I break it into two, its physics has changed. Its size has become smaller. But is there any change in its or you can say chemical composition or any new substances formed? No. So what type of change is this? This is again a physical change. If I tear this piece of cloth into two, then what happens? The pieces will become smaller and smaller, but it will remain cloth only. So is there any change in its physical or new substances formed? No. So this is again a physical change. Now, so many examples are there. If you prepare a solution of common salt, another example, solution of common salt, that is NaCl, in water. What happens when you dissolve common salt in water? Common salt is what? Solid. Now when you dissolve it in water, then it becomes, it doesn't becomes liquid, but you can say that you have got a solution of salt in water. So this is again the change in the physics, but no, without formation of new substance. So this is about the one more example of physical change. Then there are so many examples. If you light the bulb, if you put on the light, then what happens? Bulb, first it was not glowing, but when you have put it on or you have pushed the switch on, then what happens is it starts glowing. Again you put it off, then what will happen? The glow will go away. So this is a change, but there is no formation of new substance. Breaking of a glass. If you have a glass and if suppose it falls down, then what happens? It breaks into pieces. But that small piece is also, what is it? Glass. Only the physics has changed without formation of new substance. So this is called a physical change. Now next is chemical change. What is a chemical change? A chemical change is that in which new substance is formed. New substance is formed. Suppose you have a piece of carbon. Symbol of carbon is C. If you burn it in air, if you heat it in air, or oxygen part of the air is taken by it and it changes into carbon dioxide. So what kind of change is this? This is a chemical change because a new substance is formed in this. And this new substance has new properties. A change in which a new substance is formed with new properties. Here you see this is carbon, this is solid. This is oxygen, this is gas, and here what we have got is gas. Now we know that oxygen is supporter of gas. This oxygen, when it combines with carbon, it forms carbon dioxide, and this carbon dioxide, does it supports burning? No. We use it in fire extinguisher. To extinguish the fire, we can use carbon dioxide.